the question for digital divide is really all about access, which means do you have access to high-speed internet that allows you to do your daily activities and more? It's about affordability, which is can you afford the devices? And then the last one is ability. Do you have the skills and capabilities to really do whatever you need to do on the internet? And when you put all of these three together, you find that almost 3 billion people do not have access. AI can be a powerful enabler that comes on top. So what do I mean by that? In the sense that AI can help, for example, create lots of different applications. So it's really an indirect enabler rather than a direct enabler, but it can really enrich what people can get out of being digitally included. AI as well can be used for digital inclusion on the financial side. Instead of very traditional credit scoring mechanisms and disbursements mechanisms, AI can really help provide access to a whole bunch of people that perhaps would never get that financial credit using traditional methods. But AI also has some inherent challenges that we need to be conscious about. We talk about data privacy, we talk about also responsible AI, so AI without bias. And I think when this is taken care of, it does not exacerbate inequality. But if these biases come through, I think there could be people that get cut out of different benefits and value because of these biases coming in. So I think being mindful of it, keeping that in the forefront, making sure that our algorithms do not have that bias, I think is quite critical. AI, when used wisely, can be a powerful force for good for society.